Hi friends, welcome to FigJam. FigJam is a tool that can help you visually communicate and collaborate with your teams to get the input you need, drive alignment, and move your work forward. It has all of the engaging collaboration features you need to get your group engaged in meetings, and also an extensible platform to drive real power and integrate with the tools that you're using every day. And FigJam can really be a tool for any team that's having meetings, aligning stakeholders, building connections with their team. That's pretty much everyone. So FigJam can be a tool for your team, whether you're on a product team, HR, marketing, across the board, we see folks using FigJam to get their group engaged. And while there is no right way to use FigJam, there are common ways that we see our customers leveraging the value of FigJam to drive real results for their team. So today, I'm going to show you three of the most common ways that we see teams leveraging FigJam to drive real value for their teams, from ideating and prioritizing ideas, diagramming and concepting to make ideas more visual, and driving strategy and alignment to get the input that you need to make decisions. So let's dig in. When you get started in FigJam, it's an infinite canvas. You can literally create anything that you need to, but there's a few tools available to help you so you don't need to start from scratch. The first one is to start by creating a section down here in the toolbar and then use section templates. I use this all the time for running ad hoc brainstorms in a meeting if we need to start with a structure to get our group going. So I'll come in here and start with brainstorms. One of my favorites is this rapid ideations template here. If you need a more robust board to build out, you can use FigJam AI to generate a board for any specific use case or any specific meeting that you're hosting. You just tell AI what you're looking for and it will build a custom board for that need. And then we also have pre-built templates here. So if you're running a standard process, like maybe a retrospective, you could come in here and find a retrospective template that's built out of the box for you. And you can also add in your custom templates. So for the first use case that we're going to cover is ideation. So if you want to have an activity that you run regularly with your team, you can go ahead and save a custom template for that and pull it in here. So this is a standard template for ideating. I'm going to show you the features now that you can use in FigJam to power up your ideation sessions with your team. Starting with sections. I just mentioned sections a minute ago, and those are here, the keyboard shortcut Shift S. And sections essentially help you group the information on your board. This can help you sequence different content that you need to cover with your team. And you can do things like showing and hiding sections to help navigate your group through multiple activities. Then within the section, we have our objects, starting with text here. Text you can find in the toolbar here or the keyboard shortcut T. And once you place text on the board, if you click onto it, you'll see an editing menu here. So here you can do things like change the font, change the color of your text, the size, and the weighting, all of those standard text editing capabilities here. In general, when I'm ideating with my team, I recommend adding text for something like the title of your section and also some instructions of what you're expecting your team to do. And then the last thing that's critical for ideating, of course, is your standard stickies, your post-its. Stickies in FigJam you can find in the toolbar here or the keyboard shortcut S. And my best practice is to add some placeholder stickies to your board when you're ideating, just to make one last step for your team to get in and start adding their ideas. Once the stickies are on the board, you'll notice that you can do similar things like change the colors, change the font size, font type, all of those things here. And the other thing that you can do is show and hide attribution. So as your team starts adding in ideas, you can show attribution and then bring those into the discussion. Ask particular people to elaborate on the ideas that they've captured on the board. So those are the tools to get started and have your team start capturing stickies. Once you've generated a bunch of ideas, there are tools to help you then prioritize among those ideas. The simplest one is to come down here to our stamp wheel or the keyboard shortcut E and have folks place stamps on the stickies that resonate with them most. So you can do that to show reactions, to agree with different ideas, and to show some kind of light prioritization. And again, you just stamp on any object that you want to react to. If you need more powerful, robust voting mechanism, you can come up to the timer option here and go ahead and start a new vote. The voting capabilities will allow you to indicate how many votes every person gets. And then once you start that vote, each participant will be given that amount of votes and they can place those on the stickies that resonate with them most. After closing the vote, you will be able to see all of the stickies and who voted for what. You also have the timer and music. So as you're running structured activities, ideating with your team, prioritizing different things, hosting those discussions, you can time box each of those activities using our timer and playing some background music to keep the vibes going during your sessions. So those are the tools that we use for ideating and prioritizing. So to quickly recap, we have stickies. Those are to allow the team to capture ideas or place comments anywhere on your boards. Stamps to show reactions. Our timer, music, and voting to give some ambiance during our sessions and also to create structured prioritization activities. And those are all of the tools for ideation. So that's our first use case here. Next, we'll move on to concepting and diagramming. So here we'll pull in another template, our diagramming activity. And here we'll go over the features that are available for diagramming again. Similar to how we did for our board, you can use FigJam AI to automatically generate a starting point for many common types of diagrams. For example, flow charts, Gantt charts, org charts, timelines. You can bring all of those in using FigJam AI custom to your specific need. But if you want to build from scratch or you want to customize those templates that AI has created for you, the basic diagramming tools are going to be down here in the toolbar, your shapes. So if you click on the shapes options here, you'll see our shapes menu come up where you'll have several basic shapes to choose from. And then a few other options here for flowcharts and miscellaneous types of shapes. Once you place your shape on the board here, if you click into any of those shapes, you'll have some editing options again for things like color and the line type that you want to have for your shape, as well as adding things like text into your shapes. The other essential diagramming tool is your connector lines are here in the shapes menu, and you can simply select any object on your board and connect that to any other object or simply draw a line using that feature. The other diagramming functionality that you have for concept mapping, just mapping out ideas that are related to one another, are mind maps are in the shape menu here, and you can also add in things like stickies, shapes, and images to your mind map simply by dragging them into your mind map. And in your mind maps, you will have automatically laid out items. So if you add additional children or additional nodes, you can add those in with the object types that you've already created. Say you want to add an additional shape here. You can do that simply by adding additional nodes built off of the shapes and the text that you already have in here. And all of those will automatically be laid out. So that's our standard diagramming functionality that we have here. The other thing I'll note is that if you have a diagram that you'll be using regularly for your own purposes, you can always save that as a custom template, just as we've been using our activity custom templates to pull in these different modules here. You can save those custom templates by going to the share model and then publish template here. So you can publish those to your org or to a specific team in your Figma organization to allow you to easily reference those and use those every time you're creating a new diagram of a similar type. And that's our standard diagramming functionality. So now we'll move on to our last workflow of today, and I will show you how to use FigJam for driving alignment and strategic decisions. So here I'll pull in my alignment activity. And you can use a lot of the functionality that we've already covered. So oftentimes when we're driving alignment with our teams, you'll use things like text. So here you can, again, place text into a section, into whatever you're demonstrating. And then you can also pull in other assets, other media that you're using that you need to get your group to review. So if you're using Figma Design with your team, you can easily copy and paste items from Figma Design into FigJam to get a feedback from a broader group of stakeholders than you might want to bring into your design files. Another thing you can pull in is images. So you see I have this slide here of different areas that we can invest in. Once you have it here in FigJam, the tools you can use to provide feedback, we already talked about stickies, but you could ask your team to add stickies with their comments to annotate different parts of an image or an asset. And then you can also use comments. Comments are in the top left corner here, the keyboard shortcut C. And you can place that comment anywhere on the board. And you can also drag over a particular part of an image or something on the board to comment about that. And then you just type whatever your comment is. If you want to direct a comment to a particular teammate, you can start with an at sign and then type their name. And then by including their name, their at mention to that particular person, that will notify them that you're commenting to them in the board and direct their attention to respond to your comment here. Let's mock up concepts for this. Once your comment is on the board, you'll see all of your comments over here in the comments pane, and you can click into any of those comments to thread a discussion so your teammate can react to those comments. And you can also reply to those in line here. And if you're working through feedback that's been left by your team, you can resolve those as you go through and action all of the feedback. Another tool that you can use to get alignment during synchronous sessions is Cursor Chat. Cursor Chat, you can start with a slash key here. Or on the emote wheel, you can start a cursor chat from the bottom of the emote wheel. The emotes are here. The bottom of the emote wheel here is your cursor chat. And you can have discussions during synchronous sessions. asking for thoughts. Or you can say things like hi, and you can have fun reactions to those. There's also some Easter eggs there in cursor chat that you can try to uncover. And look, I already see that Mal has responded. Mal says we can absolutely mock up concepts for this, so I can show appreciation for that by reacting to her comment. And then the last tool that we often see teams using for driving alignment is using our widgets. Widgets can extend the functionality of your boards. You also have stickers where you can bring in more robust reactions. Also, you have different items that people can use to react to things on your board. And then widgets are over here to add additional power to your board. There are plugins and widgets for common tools you might be using. Say, for example, you need to create tickets for items that are captured in stickies on your board. You can bring in those widgets by simply bringing them in here. One that we often use for driving alignment is an alignment scale, aptly named. And you can find that under widgets by searching for alignment scale. That's developed by the Figma team. And here you can type in what you're asking the team to react to. And then there's a scale of how strongly they agree or disagree with that statement. All you need folks to do is click on that scale and it will show where they react. So you can have everybody react, have the results hidden, and then when you're ready, reveal those results and bring the group into discussion based on how everyone's aligned. So pulling in the folks who disagree or agree to explain more about their answer. And those are the common tools that we see folks using for driving strategy and alignment in FigJam. So to quickly recap what we covered, we talked about common ways that teams are using FigJam to jam with their teams in order to more visually communicate their ideas through things like diagramming and concept mapping, and also to drive alignment and prioritize, ideate, really engage their teams to drive the outcomes that you need. So there you have tools for ideation, strategy, and alignment. And you can use all of those tools. There's so much more power of what you can do in FigJam. You'll see other common things that we see teams doing here, and we can dig into those in the future. But I hope this gets you started in thinking about ways that you might jam with your team, and we can't wait to see how you'll jam